I could go for something cheerful.
In Enemy, the 2013 film from director Denis Villeneuve, we follow Adam Bell, a history teacher, as he discovers his doppelganger in the person of actor Anthony Clare.
There's always one obsession, and that's control. They want to have control over the people.
Adam's classroom lectures on tyranny are met with indifference, and ultimately diffused through repetition. His warning that this repeating pattern is a pathway to the loss of individuality is appropriate given his situation. The film is loaded with repeating cycles amid which Adam's sense of identity is challenged and his assertiveness drained.
They censor any means of self-expression. But it's important to remember this. This is a pattern that repeats itself throughout history.
When he discovers Anthony, who may or may not be himself, he finds that the latter is an actor, using the screen name of Daniel St. Clair. This is a loaded alter ego. The actor's identity seems doubly uncertain, as he both portrays characters other than himself and represents himself other than he is. We learn that Anthony has a history of deceiving his pregnant wife, Helen.
Who is on the phone?
Helen, the same guy who called before. The same guy. That's who's on the phone. I told you that. Why would I tell you any differently?
Are you lying to me? You're lying to me.
You're acting crazy.
I'm not crazy. Who was on the phone?
I told you it was a man who was on the phone.
Are you seeing her?
Helen, I don't want to get into this.
Are you seeing her again?
The two men are identical in appearance and voice, but not in temperament. Anthony is more aggressive, more moody. Adam is more thoughtful and compassionate. But as his mother denies that there was ever a second son, it is increasingly unclear how the two men are connected.
I am going to pretend I never heard a word of what you just told me.
I just wanted your advice.
You don't want advice. I don't want to hear any more about this. You are my only son. I am your only mother. You have a respectable job. You have a nice apartment. And since we have been frank here, I think you should quit that fantasy being a third-rate movie actor.
Although a viewer may amuse himself with speculation, I don't believe there's a logical solution in the conventional sense. Whether the story concerns a man unaware of his own double life, the intersection of two possible realities, or is simply to be taken as a metaphor, the important thing is to understand not how these events transpire, but what meaning can be gleaned from them.
Are you okay?
He had the same voice. He looks exactly like you.
What do you mean, exactly like me?
What's happening?
I really don't know what you're talking about.
I think you know.
At the beginning of the film, Anthony visits some kind of exclusive performance where gentlemen indulge voyeuristic observation of women engaged in acts that are sexually overt to varying levels.
Okay, here you go, Mr. Clare.
Thank you.
The scene culminates with the sight of a woman in heels about to squash a large spider underfoot. There's certainly something lascivious in the display, the men gathered around intensely focused on an activity that is sexualized if not sexual. The spider here clearly represents something. One might suppose it's for the men to empathize with, but its repulsive nature belies that supposition. I contend that the spider represents monogamy, something the observers consider monstrous and limiting. The sexy, anonymous woman is sensual permission to be rid of the thing. It's a sense of freedom they find in the grotesque act of crushing the spider. I think the choice of the spider is well suited for two reasons. First, for its association with the ensnaring and maintaining of unwitting victims for slow consumption, which reflects the feeling of being trapped that many men associate with romantic commitment. Second, the repulsive appearance of the animal, which stimulates a natural recoil. In the film's final shot, the audience has a sense of creepy wrongness that reflects this fear of monogamy. By the story's close, Adam and Anthony have traded places, pairing Anthony dangerously with Mary without obligation, and this leads to their deaths. Adam is left with Helen, and it seems that they are well matched, with his placid nature suitably compliant for a life of domesticity.
Why don't you come to bed?
But when he receives the key meant for Anthony, Adam immediately makes the decision to pursue the adventure of shirking that responsibility in order to explore the possibilities of sexual gratification outside of their newfound commitment.
Helen, did you plan on doing something tonight? Because I think I have to go out.
With almost no outside influence to encourage it, his view of her is immediately transformed into the image of a giant cornered spider, threatening in its entrenched defensiveness.
Helen?
For all its artfulness, the message of Enemy seems simple. Men fear commitment. But why, and who or what, is the enemy? Adam declares himself that it's all about control.
Control. It's all about control. Every dictatorship has one obsession, and that's it. So in ancient Rome, they gave the people bread and circuses. They kept the populace busy with entertainment. But other dictatorships use other strategies to control ideas, the knowledge. How do they do that? They censor any means of individual expression. And it's important to remember this, that this is a pattern that repeats itself throughout history.
He presents the idea that individuality and self-expression are suppressed by a recurring pattern of routine and censorship. Adam's life is presented to us in drab, lifeless, and diffuse visuals that reflect a sickly state of affairs, and the repetition of patterns that he himself warns against. The repellent spider imagery is associated with this feeling of being cultivated and trapped, and seems to represent the stifling influence of social conformity and the monogamous relationship Adam is expected to establish. This may explain the masculine instinct against commitment. That Adam could so easily become Anthony demonstrates how strong that inclination is. Correct or not, beneficial or not, Adam is driven by the need, if not to crush the spider, at least to recognize it for what it is. Please share your own thoughts in the comments, and like and subscribe if so inclined. If not, shoot me.
That's good. That is fucking good.